Welcome to the indices, and here we're looking at the S&P 500 on the daily chart, and you can clearly see that the market folding over back into the 1800, and will probably work lower after some sort of bounce, that may come from the 1800 or maybe just below it as well. There's good support at 1780 and 1760 as well. There is a little gap on the cash market here at 1733 here. Not that it's noticeable here, but it's there. There's also another one in here as well. So it's just, we're looking for a wave four back to the previous wave four as well. This wave four here in terms of habit came below this one here, so we need to be a little bit aware of that as well. I normally find the distance above is normally the distance below, so now it's just really a matter of tracking the wave count coming down through here, and an A wave can be in five waves or three waves. There's about, it's always debatable between 11 and 12 different types of corrections, but if we know that this is in three waves, then we can halve the dozen corrections into six possibilities, and the same with five waves down. But if we do get five waves down here, then we'll get this particular pattern here of three back up and another five down through here. So that's where we are with this at the moment. So in the move down so far on the 2 hour chart here, we can see that we've basically got five waves down and three waves back up to the 61.8 mark thereabouts. And then we're looking at another five waves down through here. So look, technically it can be an A wave, a B wave and a C wave and finish here and move back up. That's what it can do because it's in three waves. But we're looking at this in the bigger picture of it moving down further. So we would be looking at this five waves coming down through here. It was just about finished. It will probably finish in the next session. And then we'll see an A and a B and a C rally into this, maybe not this high here, depends how far it comes down through here. So 1810, 1800 here, expecting a small bounce from that point. And a lot of the other markets will be pretty much the same as well. So we've been tracking this particular five waves down through to here. And it's just still got this little bit here. Still, if I got that on, no, I don't have that, but we'll see it on the Dow where this is still a little correctional mark here. So we're looking at, let's have a look at the Dow anyway. So Dow's the same thing, but at 16,000 was our target here. So we expect a bounce from this region here. And then further down, but also we just need to be mindful that this is in three waves. So it's at one of those junctures that, it can be an A and a B and a C and be completed here. So, we really need to be mindful of that, and we need to observe what comes after. Do we get a bounce in three waves? If that's the case, then we know we're coming down further. If we get five waves up, then we know we're going to get another five up. I mean, there will be five in this first one. And three in this and five in this. But we just need to observe it and get past that particular point. But in this move here, this little move up through here on the 15 minutes chart appears to be corrective. You can see that here on the 2 minute chart here, we've got this A, B and C here. So we've got three waves here. We've also got three waves here. So it means that we will get another rally back up here in five waves, one, two, three, four and five back up into here and then roll down from that point. So we've got one more little move down here to complete this structure. Okay, looking at the DAX here, it appears that we're in a much larger correction across here, because we've never on the daily, we've never made a new high from this particular one here. So I'm just labeling this in terms of an A wave, a B wave and a C wave for the A wave, then the B wave here, because it is in three waves here. And then the C wave coming down through here. So we're looking at five waves down to just below 9,000 here. So that's what we're looking at the moment. So the structure on the way down is this here. So we've basically down for one and back for two. We do like the S&P 500 and the Dow, we do have five waves down through to here. So we would have to label this as a little wave, as a little wave one coming down through to here, then a wave two coming back and further downside here. This is it on a smaller view here. So we've got down for one, back for two, down for three, back for four, and down for five. So we're looking for the fifth wave to be finished here shortly, and then we'll see the A, B, and C. How far this actually comes back is a bit of a guessing game. You know, we can look at the 50, 60% retracement here, but I think it's sometimes better to, you know, if this move does come down a little bit further down through here, which would be nice, down to the 9.2 here, and it's probably the case because of the US coming down further, so this should follow have a bit of a follow through unless something odd happens in the Asia time frame. But look, if the 9.3 here fails as to gain support after a bounce from the 9.2 here and fails from here, then that would be it from there, and then we can look at it coming down into the 9,000 from that point there, and also too, the 9.2 is the pivot within group 1, 1, 2, and 3, really simple. Once that becomes the retested resistance, this big number here tends to pull the market down through here. It's just a matter of psychology and orders being placed at the closest largest numbers, normally even numbers and whole numbers, so to speak. So that's what we'd be looking for there. Yep, okay, the FTSE, much the same as well, slightly different pattern. I'm looking at this. This could be wrong, but we know that this is corrective through here. So I'm just labeling it as a wave four. It seems to be the sort of the best fit so far. And looking at this, is down for one here, back for two in blue, and then five waves down here in green for the third wave here, the fourth wave here, not overlapping wave one here, and then also looking for five waves down here. So if this is corrective here, then we know that this low will be taken out. We also know that there's plenty of support between 6.4 and 6.5 here. So we can expect a choppy ride here. Once again, this move down through here is in five waves, the same as the other markets. So it's still got a little bit further to go in this little fifth wave here. It's still got a little bit to go through there, so we'd probably see this having a little bounce off this sort of area here, and the same with same here, same little ABC, and then then down further. Same. So look, it's really just a matter of waiting for this low to come in, and it will come in the next session. The Australian market, I mean, we can see that the US markets are in quite a big bear market, and the European markets have still got another leg down as such. So it's highly likely that we will as well. So this move coming down through here from above 5.5 to just below 5,400 here would be in five waves. So we'd also be looking in line with the other indices, a three-wave counter trend here as such here. So that's what we're sort of looking at here, and then another move down. This is the 50-60% retracement level from here to here. I wouldn't sort of worry about that just too much. We're better off tracking the wave count, and the wave count that we've been tracking is five waves down, and on Friday we're working through here, and we can have a look in detail on that in a second. But this move down through here has got a little bit further to go. The cash market's at 54.28, I think, so it's going to open down closer to the 54 here, and leaving this market just below the 5,400 here. But like the other indices as well, they're expected to have a rally soon, so this can do the same thing from the 53.90 sort of area through here. We were looking at at this little correction across here last time we spoke. And this little move down through here, if we look at this here, is just for wave five here, is just not quite finished, a little bit like the other markets as well, so other indices. So basically we've got wave one here and wave two here. Then we've got wave one, two, three, four, and five. So this is all the third wave here. So this is the fourth wave here. It might get a bit more complicated, but then it'll be down for the fifth. So that will give us five waves to that point there. And then we should see a bit of a rally from that point. So I don't know what the catalyst will be. I can't see much information. There's a few China events, but they're all pretty insignificant, really. So anyway, we'll see how that goes from that point there. I mean, it could continue to cascade down and have some sort of extension. And the market is still over bought. Well, it's overbought at above the 5,500, and it's still overbought here. So it still has space to move lower once again here. So you just need to be a little bit mindful of that. But as I mentioned on Friday, it's very tricky when the market's in group one here. I mean, I can be proved wrong many times over, but, you've got to go with the thing that happens the most. And you can see that coming into group one here is a choppy affair. And that would be the same down here as well. If the market reaches into here, it will also be choppy as well. So it's perhaps not the best market to trade at the moment. I want to have a look at CBA as well. Actually, just while we're here, I'll just come back to the bonds market. This is the bonds here, and we can see that the bonds have still got further to go up in terms of their 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, and you can see that on the 10-year notes. This is a 2-hour chart, and this one here is a daily chart. You can see from this daily chart here that this is all corrective here, and we will be making new highs above here. So there's all these markets are going up while the S&P is doing the opposite thing and going, is the S&P here moving further down? And that's the same for the yields as well. This is the daily yields here, and you can see this is all corrective here. So trend, correction, trend. So we can see this further coming down as well. So this is why we're sort of looking at the stock market coming down further. But as I sort of mentioned the other day, we've got CBA, which is sort of, let me just get onto the right watch list here for this. I mean, it's sort of important for us to watch these leading stocks. This is CBA on the daily chart, and we've been looking at this, as you know, as an A wave to here, B and a C here, and then working up in a positive structure up here. But we've only got three waves up here so far. We're not quite finished either, but up for one, little A, B, C for two, and then up for one and back for two. And this is like the third wave moving up here. So this is all, it's still positive to the upside. Yes, there's weakness in it, and we can, expect weakness, but as long as it stays above the 75 here, or this, the top of this little guy here, then it's all pretty safe. But that's just something to look for. So a move below the 75.55 here would create a bearish, create overlapping wave structures, and it means that this particular correction here is only one leg of a larger correction in terms of a larger A wave, a B wave, and then a C wave to the downside. So that's a possibility. We've just got to keep an eye on that, because that will give us a bit of a bigger picture. I'll have a look at the ANZ, because it's actually leading. The ANZ has actually made a high above here, which also adds another layer of hope on being positive for the market, as you can see here. But it's only just moved above here. And we know that this is corrective as well in terms of an A and a B and a C here as well. But once again, this could be a B wave moving up here, then a C wave here. So a much larger A, B and C here. So we need to keep an eye on these structures, because they're the sort of the leading structures. And in the US, it's the technology and the banks that are leading to the downside. So we need to be mindful of what point we become corrective in this, because if we do get a wave C coming down, it will look something like this here. So that's quite significant, and we need to know exactly when, you know, what triggers that, and that's what we'll be sort of focusing on for the bearish side, because obviously that's going to lead the indicators lower as well. So I mean the indices. So anyway, but these are all still, all the banks are still positive for the time being. But as you know, we'll continue to focus on them, because obviously they create the index. Alrighty, I think that's sort of it. So look, nothing really sort of positive or fantastic in moves in long or short coming out of the ASX 200 or the other indices for the time being. So generally speaking, all the indices have moved down in five waves. We're waiting for some type of counter trend, and if the counter trend is clear in three waves, a 5-3-5 structure, and that's confirmed, then we can look to have another short as well. All right, thank you.